Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss the point from fourth unit, which is already we are discussing from last two lectures. From that unit, today we are going to discuss the point as the reproduction of a story. Up till now, we are. Or you can say that in last lecture we discussed the story writing, how the story can be written. That means by given whatever the points are given according to that outline, we are seeing that outline. By using the outline, we are writing the story. But here, in reproduction of a story, what we are doing in this reproduction of a story, we are writing the story by understanding or initially studying the poem. Whatever that particular contents in the poem is there, that we are first initially we are reading one, and by considering the points, subject of that particular poem, the relation of that every topic in the poem, we are writing the story. So reproduction of a story, it is done by using the some points from the poem or reading exactly the poem. For this, what we have to do, we have to consider some hints to write the story by using the poems. We have to consider the some hints to write the story from poem. What the hints are there? See, in this hint, whatever the poem it is given for the for that particular story, we have to read carefully whole poem. And whenever we are reading this particular poem, we have to slowly read this particular. Why? Because we have to understand what exactly it is contained in that poem. Or we can say that we are going to clear the concept of this particular topic of the poem. For that, first hint is that we have to read the poem. Suppose you are not getting properly from this particular first read. Whenever you are reading first time, at that time, if you are not getting that concept of the poem, then you have to read one or two times. We have to read that poem one or two times. We have to understand the concept, clear the concept of that particular poem for that topic. Clear the ideas from that particular poem, and then we have to, that means, consider that particular point for the reading, writing the story. Now, whenever we are, getting the points from that particular poem, then we have to summarize, or you can say that we have to write down some sort of the notes, key notes, or you can say that chief factors from that particular poem for the story in order wise. Then this is the second hint. Then third is that try to write the story by considering that particular concept which are you are briefly written one, you are understand what the concept of the story. And in a straightforward English, that means in simple language you have to write the story. Then, whenever you are writing this particular poem in the form of a story, that means you are reproducting the story from the poem. At that time, don't copy any language from the poem. Any sentence relate, that means considered in that particular poem, you don't copy that thing. You have to write your you have to write that particular story with your own words, own dialogues. That you have to consider here. That is the fourth hint. Whenever you are finishing this particular exercise by writing the story in your own language, by considering the your own words, but it should be considered that particular points, ideas, subject, topic from that particular poem. It is important one. Even though we are considering that particular points from our that means our own things, own words, but the concept it should be come from that particular poem, because we are writing the, we are producing the story by considering the poem points. Remember that thing. Now, whenever you are finishing such an exercise, right, it is now very important to go through whatever you are written one, you just read it one in proper manner for the reason that whether you left any point while writing the or reproducing that particular story. For that reason, you have to read once again the written story. Right? And that means this is the one thing, and that means this is the one hint. And another is that while writing any point or the, in that particular story, if any wrong statement it is inserted or it is written one, you have to find out it one, which is not related to that particular poem. For that reason, we have to read once again. This is the thing. This is the fifth hint. Now, sixth hint is that you have to finally examine your composition for any mistakes in spelling, in any grammatical mistake, in punctuations mistake. That you have to see one. That you have to examine one. Then only it will be a correct story which is written from that particular poem. See the order of the sentences. See the that particular sentences which are written or which are constructed properly or not. That you have to see once again, and then it is now ready for the your good story. You can say that. Or it is a whole composition to read well. Then only we can see that. That means these, I think, five hints are there, which is considered to write a story from the poem. See, normally, reproduction of this particular story, it is considered from the poem concept. So that may be, that poem may be shorter one, that may be some sort of the longer poem is there. And that poem you have to consider one, and according to that you have to write the story. But you have to take the care about these things. That means once again I am summarize the points. You have to read the poem carefully so that you will get the clear idea about that particular poem, the topic for which that particular poem it is written, or the subject which for which it is written one. Then you have to write down some sort of the key notes or chief factors from that particular poem for the story. Then you have to, whenever you are noting, that means you are preparing the notes for the writing the story, then you have to start by using the that particular idea by reading the two or more than two times that poem and the key points. You have to start the writing the that particular story, and it should be in a proper simple English language, straightforward. It should be written in a straightforward in simple English language. Use your own words for the writing the this story. Don't use any dialogues from the poem. Whenever you are finishing such a exercise, you have to go through that particular written story so that you will get the idea whether the story it is written in a proper way or not, any point it is missed from that particular poem, or by mistake if any unnecessarily wrong things it is inserted in the story. If such a thing is there, then you have to take care about this thing. And finally, you have to examine your that particular story by considering the composition of that particular mistakes. That means spelling mistake, grammatical mistakes, or that punctuations which are considered in the writing the story. You have to take care about all these things and see the order of that particular sentences which is written for that particular story. It is important one. And when you are going through all these things, then this is the, you can see that well composed story. That means your composition is well one to read the all this story. You can see that, right? So this care you have to take the while writing the or while reproducing the story from the poem. What this thing? So here I am written one small example. You can see that it is a small, but it is not that much small one. Here, see here, this is I written in a black pen, right? These points are come from the, you can see the story, poem, right? And this poem, it ends here. All the points are considered, and by considering that poem's points, I am again reproducing this particular story so that it is again considering with that particular, you can see that poem's dialogues. It is considered by the poem's dialogue, right? So in that manner you can consider one for that writing the story, or you can say that reproducing the story from the poem. See, this reproduction, it is, you can see that different from the story writing. Remember that one. Story writing, it is some outlines it are they are given one, and from that outline you are filling that particular points in your own language, considering the that particular points from the outline, and you are ordering that particular thing, and you are rewriting the story so that it gets some sort of the thing. But in this particular you can say that poem, reproducing the story from the poem, you have to understand the given poem. That may be shorter poem may be there, that may be having some sort of the lengthy poem. You have to understand that particular poem. You have, and for that reason, because some poems are not directly giving the idea about that concept, and for that reason you have to read that poem one, two, or more than two times. You have to carefully understand, memorize that particular key facts from that particular poem, and then you have to, that means, try to write the story, reproduce the story. That's why it is said that reproduction of the story from the poem, not from that particular outline. Because why it is so, is called as a reproduction? Because it is already written in the form of the poem. Got this thing? It is already written in the form of the poem. Only thing is that instead of a poem, you have to write in the that particular sentences so that it can be easily understandable for the any person. And for that reason, you have to write the story. For that reason, this particular point, it is called as the reproduction of a story. Getting my point? Okay, remember this thing. And I think in your that previous school time might be such a thing. I am also not aware about this particular thing, whether it is previously it is happened with your that particular 5th to 10th or 12th standard. I am not having that particular idea, but might be it is new for you people. Might be in exam what they will give. They will give the one poem and they will ask you write the, reproduce the story. So during that you have to understand or remember these things while writing, reproducing this such a kind of a story. But this thing, once again, if any doubt related to this, you can ask me. Already I shared the email ID to you. Once again, I am reminding you people that the objective of this particular unit is to develop the communication skill. Object of this particular unit, fourth unit, is the develop the communication skill. Okay, guys, be ready for the. That means you have to read these particular things. You have to study this particular thing and be ready for the. That means whatever the exams which may be considered afterwards. So I will again. Last time I shared you that I will provide you these notes to you people so that you will get the. That means some sort of the idea for writing the this particular. That means points in the exams. Thank you.